Welcome friends, welcome to another video lecture of Biovision Academy. And friends, today in NMR we are going to discuss about shielding and deshielding. Okay friends, before discussion of shielding and deshielding, I would like to suggest you to watch two previous videos which is based on NMR. Okay friends, those videos will help you to understand about the shielding and deshielding. But for now, let's understand what is shielding and deshielding. Okay friends, let's discuss this. Students, suppose that this is a molecule A and this is the molecule B. Okay students, you know that every molecule has an atom and every atom has a nucleus, and a nucleus is positively charged due to proton, and around the nucleus cloud of electrons are present. Okay now, and you also know that nucleus has the property to rotate around its own axis. Okay, there are two nucleus which are positively charged and they are rotating around its own axis. Okay now students, you know that when a charged body rotate, it behave like a magnet and generate magnetic field. Okay so you can observe that here nucleus is also positively charged and it is also rotating around its own axis. It means it is also behaving like a magnet and generate magnetic field. Okay and this is the direction of the magnetic field. This is the north and this is the south. Here you can observe that second atom is also positively charged, it is also rotating around its own axis, so it is also behave like a magnet. Okay it is also behave like a magnet. Now students, you can observe that in first molecule there is a dense cloud of electrons are present around the nucleus. It means there are large number of electrons present around the nucleus, and in second molecule the number of electrons are very less. So students, the first nucleus in which a large number of electrons are present, or you can say large number of electrons cover the nucleus, so such kind of nucleus in which around it a large number of electrons, or you can say cloud of electrons are present, is known as shielded nucleus or shielded magnet. It is the shielded nucleus. And in second case you can observe that the nucleus is surrounded by very less number of electrons, or you can say there are negligible electrons. Suppose that it is a hydrogen atom and in this hydrogen atom only a single electrons are present. So such kind of nucleus around which a very less number of electrons are present, or you can say very less number of electrons are present, so such nucleus is termed as deshielded, is known as deshielded. Okay student, for understanding you can call shielded as a covering or deshielded as a uncovered. Okay now students, suppose that it is a NMR chamber, and in this NMR chamber magnet is present. Okay this is magnet, this is also a magnet, this is magnet, and this is also a magnet. Got it? Now students, when we put this nucleus into the chamber, okay now this is the direction of applied magnetic field. Okay, by using the magnet of NMR machine, we create an external magnetic field, and this external magnetic field is known as an applied magnetic field, and this is the direction of applied magnetic field. This is north, north and north. Got it? Now students, when we put this shielded nucleus into the NMR chamber, then this applied magnetic field causes the alignment of this nucleus, or you can say it is try to put this nucleus into its own direction. But due to shielding, the effect of applied magnetic field on this nucleus is very less. So this nucleus is not completely aligned in the direction of an applied magnetic field. And now this magnet will got position like this. Okay, now this is north and this is south, and here the dense cloud of electrons are present. Got it? Dense cloud of electrons are present. Okay students, I'm telling you, when we put this nucleus into the NMR chamber, then applied magnetic field try to pull the north direction of this nucleus into its own north direction. But due to shielding of electrons, the complete force of an applied magnetic field is not created on the nucleus. Or in other words, you can say that this cloud of electron oppose an applied magnetic field, or you can say the direction of applied magnetic field. So the nucleus is not completely aligned in the direction of an applied magnetic field, and this state is known as alpha state. You already know that alpha state. Got it? Now students, if we provide an energy to the nucleus which is present in alpha state in the shielded form, okay, suppose that this is the radio frequency in the form of energy, then this nucleus absorbs this radio frequency, and now the position is just shift, and now this nucleus got this position. Okay, got it? Now it means, now the nucleus absorbs energy to shift its position from alpha state to beta state. This is beta state, and to shift its position from alpha state to beta state, nucleus has to travel this distance. Okay, you can say from 180 degree to 90 degree, which is a very less distance. Okay, now, and to travel such a distance, the amount of an energy absorbed by the nucleus is very low in a shielded form. Okay, now let's understand the second form, that is the deshielded form. You can observe that in deshielded form there is no electrons present around the nucleus. So when we put this nucleus into the NMR chamber, then due to an applied magnetic field, this nucleus is completely aligned in the direction of an applied magnetic field. Suppose that this is the south, 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 this is north, 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 and when we put this magnet into this, then this nucleus is completely aligned in the direction of an applied magnetic field. Okay, and why it happened? Because due to less number of electrons, this nucleus is not able to oppose the direction of an applied magnetic field, and it is completely aligned in the direction of an applied magnetic field. Okay, now, and now if you provide and energy to this nucleus in the form of radio frequency. Then this nucleus absorb this radio frequency, and now from alpha state, this nucleus shift its position, and now it changes into beta state. Okay, this is beta state. So beta state is that state of a nucleus in which the direction of an applied magnetic field and the direction of the magnetic field of the nucleus are in opposite direction. Okay, so now students, you can observe that in alpha state the nucleus has to travel this distance to shift its position from alpha state to beta state, and this distance is a very large distance. So the nucleus in a deshielded molecule absorb very high amount of energy, to shift its position from alpha state to beta state. See, now nucleus in this, and now it has to travel this long distance. Okay, this is the distance in deshielded molecule, and this is the distance in a shielded molecule. So this distance require very low amount of energy, and this distance require very high amount of energy. Okay, so now students, you are able to understand why there is a low amount of energy is required in a shielded molecule, because in a shielded nucleus, nucleus has to travel a very less distance, and due to less distance, low amount of energy is required. But in a deshielded molecule, nucleus has to travel a very long distance, and due to long distance, it require very high amount of energy. Okay, low and high. So in a shielded molecule, shifting of position from alpha state to beta state, low amount of energy is required. Low energy. Okay, got it? And in a deshielded molecule, shifting of nucleus from alpha to beta state require high amount of energy. High energy. Got it, students? Now students, let's draw a graph of a molecule which are present in shielded and deshielded. Okay, let's draw a graph. Let me rub this out. Okay, this is the graph. Okay, now this is the increasing order of energy. Okay, so first deshielded shielded molecule, and shielded molecule require a very less amount of energy. So this, and deshielded molecule require a very high amount of energy. So the peak should be like this. This is for the molecule A, and this is for the molecule B. Okay friends, so this is the energy. Okay, now friends, let's understand this overall shielding and deshielding by taking the example of an organic compound. Okay, let's understand this. Students, let's take the example of an organic compound, and the compound is chloroethane. Okay, student, this is chloroethane. Now you can observe that if you draw this compound, then we should draw this like this. Okay, now suppose let's consider this compound A and this considers compound B. Okay, now students, CH3 is an electron donating group. Okay, it is electron donating group. Electron donating group. Okay, and this chlorine is an electron withdrawing group. Electron withdrawing group. Okay, it means chlorine absorb, or you can say it pull the electron from this CH2, whereas CH2 is a donating electrons to this CH3. CH3 and CH2 are electron donating group. So due to the electron withdrawing property of chlorine, the atom, that is a proton, this and this are very deshielded. Are deshielded. Okay, and this molecule B is closer to the CH2, and CH2 is an electron donating group. So due to the electron donation, this CH2 donate electrons to the CH3. So the CH3 is now shielded. Okay, students, please mind, the electron withdrawing property is a very local effect. So the electron withdrawing property of chlorine only affect the CH2. It is not able to affect the CH3. So the chlorine group absorb the electron, or you can say pull the electron towards itself. So due to the pulling of electron from CH2, this CH2, or you can say the protons in CH2, now deshielded, and due to the electron donating property, this CH2 donate the electron to the CH3. So now CH3 is shielded. So suppose that this is the nucleus of CH2, or you can say proton is A. This is north and this is south, and this is the nucleus of B. This is north and this is south. So B is highly shielded with electrons, where it is A is less shielded to electron. So shielded molecule require very less amount of energy to shift its position from alpha to beta. Alpha to beta, very less energy, low energy. And the molecule which are present in a deshielded form, that is A, require very high amount of energy. So it is high energy. Let's draw the graph of this. This is the increasing order of an energy. Okay, now the CH2 is a deshielded, it means it require a very high amount of energy, and the B molecule is shielded, so it is required very less amount of energy. So in graph, when we do NMR, two peaks are absorbed And by observing the peak, we can say that the low amount of energy, if the peak is low, it means the molecule is shielded. So, and the shielded molecule is CH3. This is B. Okay. And if the high amount of energy is required, it means peak is high, and we can say that the second group is CH2. So students, by observing the intensity, or you can say height of peak, we can say that which molecule is shielded and which molecule is deshielded. Okay friends, so friends, now this is the third part in NMR which deals with the shielding and deshielding. Okay friend, so friends, I hope this overall discussion will help you to understand about the shielding and deshielding. Okay friends, in the next part we will discuss about the NMR active and NMR inactive molecules. Okay, so friends, I hope you like this video. So friends, if you like this video, then please share this video with your friends. Please do subscribe our channel, and please friends, don't forget to press the bell icon, so next time when we upload a new video, you will get the notification. Okay friends, so friends, thank you very much for your precious hearing. Have a nice day.